Students, it's time to begin the chapter 2 for the unit 1st. It is the matter of class 12 biology. The name of chapter 2 is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. The other name of flowering plants is angiospermic plants. Why angiospermic plants are called flowering plants? Because in them the flowers are well mature and consist all the necessary devices that are helpful for the reproduction process. So you should study it carefully and focus on the important concept regarding this lesson. This is a very important lesson than the previous lesson. One by one we will describe about the different topics as a heading for you. The first heading for this heading is the flower. Keep in mind the flowers basically define as the fascinating organs of the modified shoot. Fascinating organs of the modified shoot of plants is known as flower. And different way you can explain by the help of the class 11th morphology notes. That is chapter 5, class 11th. You have studied it very carefully, so you have a pre-mindset regarding the flower. Now next topic is, it is your homework to define the flower. Now next topic is features of flower. Flowers are modified shoot. Almost there are two part of the flower plants. The you can if write it as a plant, that is the upper part of the plant that is above the ground is shoot, and the lower part of the plant that is below the ground is called as root. So plants are actually shoot part of plants are actually consist the flower, which if you see carefully then you will find the plants flowers are actually just like the petals, sepals just seems like a leaf, petals just like a colorful leaf, sepals just like the original leaves. Actually the main function of petals, sepals are actually performing the photosynthesis. Now back to the next second features of the flowers. Flowers are actually fascinating organ. Fascinating means attractive. Why attractive? Because it helps to attract the insect at the time of pollination. So it should be the flowers are called fascinating organs. Now back to the point third regarding the features of flowers. The actually features of flowers, maybe point one and two is over. Point third, flowers consist reproductive devices. Keep in mind reproductive devices. Devices means the equipment that help for the reproduction process. Basically you have pre-mindset regarding this is the androecium and gynoeciums are actually the reproductive devices. So don't be confused regarding this. Now back to the floriculture. Floriculture means culture and marketing of the ornamental flower. Culture and marketing of ornamental flower. Culture means to grow and marketing means for the economical purpose. You should help for the flowers as to grow your economy and support for the country, also for your society. Ornamental flowers are those flowers that can be grown in garden for the decorating and for well fascinating facility. Fascinating facility means ornamental flowers are actually very attractive flowers, like the rose, marigold, etc. are in the category of ornamental flower, and they are actually they can actually grow in the garden and in the pot, etc. So ornamental flower, don't be confused. Ornamental flowers are those flowers that can be grow for the decorating purpose, but economically it should be it can be grow in large amount for selling it, for marketing it, in order to support the economy. So ornamental flowers may be asked in the examination. Floricultures may be asked in the examination. So it should be in your mind. Now next, the list of ornamental flowers like rose, marigold, and there are so many. 5 is your homework. Which kinds of flowers may be available in your garden? So search it and write it regarding this. 3 more should be left. Now next heading is structure of a complete flower. Structure of a complete flower. Complete flower means flowers that consist all the necessary equipment for the reproduction process, like the anther, filament, stigma, style, petal, sepal, etc. In examination it should be asked as the LS of, draw the LS of a complete flower. So don't be confused regarding the LS complete flower. LS complete flowers are actually given in your book, so it may be asked in the examination. Students, now we are going to label each and every part of a complete flower. It is very important regarding diagram and structures. It may be asked in examination, so keep in mind, see carefully the diagram of each part. First part is anther lobe. Anther lobe is actually the male reproductive part of male reproductive system. It is dithecous anther because of having two lobe. So inside the each lobe there is the sac like structure known as microsporangium, in which pollen grains are mature and become grow. Now next part is filament. Filament help to attach the anther lobe with the main part of flower, that is thalamus. So the anther lobe and filament collectively form the stamen. The stamen is male reproductive system. Now next very important part is thalamus. Thalamus is also known as receptacles, that actually the support for the each and every part of flowers, like anther, filament and sepals, petals, etc. The receptacle, the other name of receptacle is thalamus. So don't be confused the two name of thalamus. Keep in mind the receptacles and thalamus. So the male and female reproductive system are actually the chief reproductive system of the each sexually reproducing organisms. Now back to the female reproductive system of the flower. The main female reproductive system of angiospermic flower is stigma, style and ovary. So we should begin from the stigma. Stigma is actually broader and typical part of the angiospermic flower, and this allow to landing of pollen grains at the time of pollination. Just after the stigma there is the tubular style, and this help to carry the pollen tube at the time of pollen tube germination. Inside the pollen tube the male gametes exist. So back to back, stigma and style are the typical part of female reproductive system, and this help for the carrying and growth of the pollen grains at the time of pollination. So stigma, style, that is the broader stigma and style are the typical part of female reproductive system. Just after the style there is a swollen part of ovary, and these key stigma, style and ovary form the female reproductive system. It is also known as gynoecium. Keep in mind, with respect of gynoecium there is another name of male reproductive system, that is also known as androecium. So don't be confused, androecium for the male reproductive system and gynoecium for the female reproductive system. Other name of these stigma, style and ovary is also known as carpel. So it is very key concept of the male and female reproductive system. The inside the ovary there is the ovule exists, sometimes it is also known as megasporangium, and inside the ovary there is egg cell before fertilization, but after fertilization it become embryo. So where is embryo exist? Embryo exists inside the ovary. Now back to the next supportive part of the flowering parts. Supportive means it do not directly participate in the process of fertilization, but it is very helpful. For example, the petals is actually the collection of several petals are also known as corolla. It is colorful in nature. And next one is the sepals. The collection of sepals is known as calyx. This is the collection of sepals. Sepals are almost green in color in all flower, but petals may be colorful, red color, yellow color, pink color, etc., which help to attract the insect during the pollination, and very helpful for the transfer of pollen grains from the other flower to the one flowers. Keep in mind, it is the complete diagram of LS of a angiospermic flower. It is very important diagram, and you should label it, you should learn it, and you should also practice it one by one. You should take it the take as a screenshot regarding practice and also making a notes. This is helpful for you, and this is helpful for your examination, better preparation. And you should label as the LS of a complete flower. So you should write it and draw it. Thank you.